out on bail and till the time of the judgment. The judgment we're talking about, guilty or not guilty, that judgment. During that time, a huge amount of, you know, like people's perception had completely overturned.
But the, as I said earlier, I would repeat it to answer this particular question, whether pro Sanjay camp had swollen and the anti-Sanjay camp had declined, you know. But that is not relevant according to us. You know, you may go on, thousands or millions and millions of people will stand for Sanjay. That is not going to affect the judge or the criminal procedure, so, which has happened. So therefore, I don't think that his becoming superhero or his winning sympathies of millions of Indians, you know, had anything to contribute in the ultimate findings of the trial judge. I think it is not correct.
The judgment day in this case, the 2006 guilty not guilty, what did that mean to Sanjay?
Well, naturally, Sanjay Dutt was one among several persons who received the verdict, either of acquittal or of guilt, and if of guilt, what punishment. It was all procedure as usual. And Sanjay was just one ordinary person like anybody else as far as this procedure was concerned.
Could you recall that day?
But that day I was in the studio of a television and we were live chatting and we were shown how Sanjay was asked to come in the witness box, what is the judge asking, because that particular day as an exception, the learned trial judge had allowed the media people with camera and everything to be inside. So we were directly, every moment, every second, you know, we were counting, and then the media anchor was, television anchor was asking me, now what do you suggest, what do you propose, what do you predict, and we were speculating. And ultimately, you know, it was made public that he was held guilty for under Arms Act, and he was declined the benefit of release under Probation of Offenders Act.
I'm assuming that meant a lot, because the very word terrorist was something which he was...
Yeah, finding. Terrorist was deleted even earlier before sentence was awarded, because there was one exercise of pronouncing him guilty or not. There was second important event of exercising the powers of awarding sentence. So on both occasions, you know, the tensions were very high, mounting tension, and speculations were there, all eyes were set on the media, you know, developments, and ultimately we saw the results.
What, just a supposition, what if he was found guilty under TADA?
Well, that would have been certainly disastrous, but it was only a finding of a trial court, which is not always final. The first appeal is a constitutional right. Sanjay has done it. We must not even take for granted that he has been held guilty under Arms Act, therefore he is guilty. You know, it is again sub judice. The higher courts would examine the finding of guilt and the award of sentence. So, if he had been held guilty under, hypothetically under TADA, again he would have challenged it, and again Supreme Court would have considered it. So, it is not proper for any one of us to finally judge as to whether he is guilty or not, the matter being sub judice. Okay.